Slideshow is a cost option for Inspect, free if you're under SMA, which allows Inspect to show an alternate view during execution. Key dimensions are displayed over one or more slides, with the label color indicating whether they are in or out of tolerance. To use Slideshow, you need to ensure you have the Slideshow add-on installed. Run Inspect as administrator to check and install it if necessary. In settings, you can decide if you want a PDF of the slideshow automatically created, and you can also indicate who should be able to create slideshows. In order to have a slideshow view for a routine, you need to manually configure it. Select a routine and press the Create Template button in the Slideshow section of the Details panel. This will launch the Slideshow Template Editor view. It will also automatically launch PC-DMIS in the background, so it can take a few moments to appear. The first thing we will look at is how to change the report to have your company logo. To do this, click on the Header Footer tab and select the Hexagon logo in the top left. Then, using the property in the lower right, browse to a JPEG or PNG that you want to use. Now we've got the header taken care of, let's click on the Slides tab and look to add an image of the part. There's two ways we can do this. The first is to drag the image control onto the page and then browse to an image file, similar to how we changed the report logo. The second way, and easiest if you currently have an image in the clipboard, is to Control V to paste it straight in. Resize and position the image as necessary, and then click on Dimensions to start defining which key dimensions you'd like the operators to see. All dimensions in the routine are listed. You can choose to add all of them, or perhaps you just want to focus on a few key critical ones. Again, drag and drop will move the items onto the page. Dimensions that have been added will have the page number added next to their name, so you can easily see which ones you've referenced already. You can use the layout controls, similar to how you'd use them in other Windows applications, to help you align the dimension boxes and make it look professional. Position them and connect the leader lines to the features of interest. You can easily add more pages by pressing the plus icon. With the new page, again, add an image. This time I will select from a file. You can have a different view of the part, whatever makes the most sense to highlight the next set of dimensions. Then continue to drag more dimensions on and locate the leader lines again. As you add dimensions, try to keep dimensions close in the list on the same page. This will avoid the slideshow swapping back and forth too much at execution time. It should also be noted that you will have the best experience if your routine has the dimensions evaluated as soon as the feature that they relate to is measured. This will give you a steady stream of dimension results in real time. If your dimensions are all at the end of the routine, then the slideshow won't start updating right until the end of execution. Keep adding pages and dimensions until you've created your slideshow. When you're happy, you can press the save icon in the lower right, close the editor and return to Inspect. Now, if you press play to execute a routine and swap to the slideshow view, you will see your slideshow in action, updating dimensions as they are measured. At the end, if you selected the automatically create PDF setting, then you'll also be able to click on the report item to view the PDF. This will be a permanent copy of the same data that was displayed during execution. You will also be able to access these historically in the All Reports section, where you can use the filters to help locate a slideshow from an earlier run.